also knows deep in his heart that Donald Trump couldn't find Ukraine on a map if you had the letter U and a picture of an actual physical crane next to it. He knows that this is, you know, an administration defined by ignorance of the world. And so that's partly him playing to their base and playing to their audience, you know, the credulous boomer rube demo that backs Donald Trump, that wants to think that Donald Trump's a smart one, and there are y'all elitists are them.
You elitists with your geography and your maps and your spelling, even though my
your math and your reading.
That was good. Sorry, Rick. That was a good one. I needed that.
Aw, look at you with your cosmopolitan bias. The liberal network getting intense backlash, and the president is fighting back, saying, quote, Don Lemon, the dumbest man on television with terrible ratings, end quote. Ivanka Trump calling the clip disgusting. So, Greg, does this is this one of those moments where the media left show their bias against a large chunk of the country?
Well, first, I want to tell you, I did come up with a drink called the Lemon Ricky. It's half pompous, half ass. I don't really...
Rant!
You know, I'm all for ridicule. You ridicule the guy, though. And what the problem with CNN is they ridicule everybody. People. And this has always been kind of their thing. It's like they really do look down their noses at least half of America. It's no wonder their ratings are in the tank. That is a pure campaign ad. Somebody's got to make it. But I will say this. Rick Wilson, there is definitely something wrong with him. I don't know what it is, but there's something wrong with him. The joke wasn't that bad. It was Lemons just overdoing it, hyper dramatic. Oh my God, this is the best thing ever. Like he was having an orgasm.
Like Jimmy Fallon on SNL.
Yeah, yes. No, not. Don't ever soil Fallon by comparing him to Don Lemon. But it killed me. The overreaction was just so silly and sad. And CNN's in trouble and they need help. No wonder they're watching us all the time. They have their media crew watching Fox to figure out what we're doing right.
They've got their eyes on you.
Yes.
Well, maybe it's respecting people's votes and people's points of view, even when they don't score with your own. And I think that that's one of the biggest problems. What do you see here?
Well, many people are the first to try to point out, and you know, I'll put like Rick Wilson and others, when the president says something impolite or harsh about another person, they will immediately, and I don't like it either. I've said that from the beginning. I don't although my nickname I really liked was Little Rocket Man. That was my favorite one. But other than like ones that are personal in nature, I don't like. And then I also knew that as soon as Hillary Clinton said deplorables, like that was it. Like, here we go. And also I don't understand, I guess using a Southern accent to mimic somebody who apparently is dumb and doesn't read is really offensive. I mean, people come from different regions of the country. You have accents from people from all over the world. It has nothing to do with your intelligence. It has to do with where you were raised. And so that I think, is offensive.
Yeah, how many surgeons have Southern accents? I'm pretty sure a million.
Yeah, that's why I don't make sweeping generalizations about large groups of people, Greg.
Thank you, Jesse.
It's just
really?
Not right.
Is that like today, starting now?